This PHP SMS Quick Start covers both inbound and outbound SMS. Your application makes a post request to Twilio, and Twilio sends a text message. It's that simple. We'll start in the terminal by installing the Twilio PHP helper library using Composure. Composure helps you manage your third-party dependencies for your PHP applications. Next, we'll create a sendmessage.php file and open it in a text editor. We'll require the Twilio helper library that we just got from Composure and declare that we'll use the Twilio REST client object. Next, we'll need some account credentials, namely the account SID and auth token for our Twilio account. These will look like this, but I have these stored in environment variables, so we use those values instead. Pull the account SID and auth token from environment variables. We'll use those credentials to create a Twilio REST client, passing in both the account SID and the auth token. Then we'll use the client to create a message, and that message is going to need to be sent to a phone number. Phone numbers that we use in Twilio look like this, but once again, you guessed it, I have my phone number stored in an environment variable, so let's get it from there. Then we'll pass in an array of parameters for a text message. The from number will be the Twilio phone number that we just purchased from the console. And then we'll pass in a body, which is the text that'll get sent in the SMS. We'll say hello from the Twilio PHP Quick Start. Heading back over to the terminal, we'll run our PHP file, and a text message will appear on our phone. It's that easy. Now let's talk about inbound SMS. A user sends a text message to your Twilio phone number. Twilio makes an HTTP request to your app, and your app returns some instructions in the form of something called TwiML. If the TwiML looks like this, then Twilio sends a text message back to the user's phone. Let's write the code to make that happen. We'll create a respond.php file that'll hold the TwiML response that Twilio will request when a text message comes in. We'll set the content type header to text XML, since TwiML is just XML. And then we'll create a response tag that will be returned to Twilio when the text message comes in. That response will include a message that says, "Thanks for messaging me." Back in the terminal, we'll fire up a server on localhost port 8000. There's only one problem with this. Twilio can't reach localhost port 8000 publicly, so we use a tool called ngrok to create an HTTP tunnel on port 8000. This will allow Twilio to access the server code that's running at localhost port 8000 with an HTTP GET request. We'll take the URL that was generated for this tunnel and take it over to the phone number console for the phone number we set up earlier. We'll paste in the URL in a message comes in webhook and add respond.php to it. We'll make sure we're specifying an HTTP GET request since our server will return the TwiML from a GET request. Next, we'll take our phone and fire off a text message back to our Twilio phone number, and Twilio sends the response.